your parents and don't go outside, play indoor games and stay safe at your home. So kids, once again I welcome the entire students of class UKG over here. My name is Ms. Rashmi Chetri. So kids, today we are going to start with maths, okay? Usually we start with English, but today we will be starting with maths, okay? So the name of the book is Easy Learning Maths. Everyone say with me, the name of the book is Easy Learning Maths. So have a look at the book and just take it out and let's open to page number 28, okay? And before that, before proceeding, I want to tell you that we are skipping some of the pages, some of the chapters, like these all, we are skipping this one. We will do these part later on, okay? Because these are number same and it will take a little bit more time to do all this. So we will do it later, okay? So today, we will be doing this page, that is page number 28. And the topic is more than, less than and equals to, okay? So just have a look at the board. This is what we are going to do today. Okay, you can see here in the board that I have drawn some pictures over here and these are the signs that I have made, okay? So what is this now I'm going to tell you? Just look very carefully, okay? So here you can see, first of all let's count, okay? These all are stars, right? So let's count the both parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are total, in this side what we have got, there are total 5 stars. And here in this side, count with me, okay? Don't just see the video, count with me, okay? Here you can see 1, 2, 3, 4 stars are there, right? Here how many stars we have got? There are 5 stars. And here you can see there are 4 stars total. And you have to remember, you have to keep in mind these things that ये जो arrow है ना, ये the arrow you can see here, ये arrow ना उसी side में open होगा जहाँ पे greater, the numbers are greater, okay? This will be, suppose this is the mouth of a fish, okay? Fish ना you know machli, right? Suppose just for an example, this is the mouth of a fish, okay? So the mouth of a fish will open only in that side where the things or the numbers are greater. Okay, suppose here how many stars are there? There are total 5 stars. And here you can see there are total 4 stars. So now it is very clear where this will be opened. Definitely is side mein khulega. Okay, you have to remember this thing that this arrow will be opened only in that side where the numbers or the things are greater, okay? So here this part is greater, so we will open the mountain in that side. And the second important thing is we have to remember that which part is greater or less than. Suppose we have opened this side only, okay? First thing what we have done, that this mouth will be opened only in that side where the numbers are greater, right? But we also have to compare both this. There are 5 stars and there are total 4 stars, right? So here we have opened. Ye toh is side mein khulega nahi greater mein, but we have to remember, we have to compare these two things. That means this one, these stars are greater than this. Okay? So for second example, look here, okay? Have a look. First of all, what is this? These all are circles, right? So count with me how many circles are there, okay? There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many circles are there? There are total 5 circles. And this side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This one is, there are total 6 circles. Now where the mouth will open, where the mouth of the fish will be opened? Of course, this side. Because as I told you that, these arrow, the mouth will open only in that side where the things are or the numbers are greater. जहाँ पे जिस side पे ज़्यादा है, okay? Here the circles are 6, and this side you can see there are total 5 circles. So definitely we will open the mouth in greater there, okay? But now let's compare it. There are 5. Now there are 6. As we have opened the mouth this side. Now second thing, what I told you that we have to compare. So this is less than this part. These circles are less than these parts. Okay? So what first thing, what we have learned? Here we have opened this side in this way because the numbers of stars are here more, right, than this comparing to this. And here we have opened the mouth this side we have opened the mouth. But secondly, what, how we will compare, what we will say that this is less than this one. These circles are less than these circles, okay? In this way we have to do all this, alright? Now what is this? This is the sign of equals to. Means, suppose, just have a look over here. There are 1, 2, 3. 3 stars, there are total 3 stars. And let's count this side also. 1, 2, 3. There are total 3 stars. Now both the numbers, both the number of the stars are equal. So what we will do here, we will not open the mouth anywhere. We will make a sign over here in this way. That means this is equal to. Matlab ki both sides are equal. Either may be 3 stars hai, either may be 3 stars hai. If the both numbers are equal, then we will make a sign like this. Okay? If the, if this sign appears, that means both sides are equal. Okay? I hope that you all have understood. Okay, just let me do a recap. Okay? So, first thing what we have learned, the first point, that we will always open this mouth on that side where the numbers are greater. And secondly, what we have learned, that we have to compare both of the things. After opening the mouth, after making an arrow, we will compare both the sides, this side also and that side also. Okay, that which one is greater and which one is less than. And the third thing what we have learned today is this one. Okay, that means equals to. So, if this sign appears, that means the both sides are equal. Matlab ki yahan pe bhi same numbers hai. Suppose for example, here is also 3, here is also 3. So, if this sign appears, that means the both sides are equal. Matlab ki is side mein bhi same number hai aur is side mein bhi same number hai. Okay, so that this is the sign of equals to. Okay. I hope that you all have understood this. So let's do this exercise, okay? This is page number 28. Now read along with me, okay? Draw a ring around the box with more fruits. You have to draw a circle over the picture which has more fruits. Matlab jis side mein zyada picture fruits hai, us side mein we have to make a draw a circle, okay? So what you can see here, There are two baskets, right? One and two. And what is there in the basket? There are apples. So let's count it, which one has more fruits, because we have to circle that picture only which contains more fruits. Okay, so let's count. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 apples are there in this side and here. 1, 2, and 3. 3 apples are there, right? So which one is greater? Which basket contains more fruits? This side, this one, right? So you have to circle over here. Put a circle, make a circle over here, okay? Similarly, we are going to do this one also. Here, what we need to do? Again, there is two. There are two baskets and the basket contains bananas, right? So let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are total 7 bananas. And over here, 1, 2, 3. There are total 3 bananas. Now it is very clear which basket contains more fruits, which basket contains more bananas. This one. So you have to make a circle over here. Okay? Because the question is given like, draw a ring. Draw a circle around the box with more fruits. Jo basket mein zyada fruits hai, you have to circle that only, okay? So in this way you will do your question, you will do this exercise by yourself, and it is very easy, no need to take the help of your parents, alright? So let's move on to the second one. Draw a ring around the plate with less vegetables. Here what we have done, more means zyada and less means kam, okay? You have to draw a circle around the picture which contains less vegetables. Jisme kam hai, okay? So let's count first. These are cucumbers, right? So here you can see 1, 2. 2 vegetables are here, there, and this side 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 vegetables are there, right? So which one you will circle? Which picture you will circle? Definitely this one. Because why we are going to circle here less one? Because in the question itself it is written that we need to make a circle over the less vegetables, jahan pe kam vegetables ho, okay? So here there are only two vegetables, so we have to circle these part, okay? Now let's move on to the second one. The same thing, okay? There are 1, 2, 3 tomatoes, and here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tomatoes are there. So which one is less? Less matlab kam. Which picture contains less vegetables? This one. So you have to circle this part, okay? So it was very easy. So you will do this exercise by yourself, okay? Now if you turn the page, page number 29, if you move on to page number 29, you will be getting this type of image, okay? So now here what we have to do is, as I have taught you in the board, more than, less than and equals to, right? Just now few minutes later I have explained you how we have to do, where the mouth will be opened, and if the same numbers are there, which sign we have to make, right? So here what we need to do is draw this mark, as I have done in the board. Draw this type of mark according to this stocks, okay? So let's do it. These are mangoes. What is this? These are mangoes. So let's count here in this column. 1, 2, 3. 3 mangoes are there, and this side only 1 mango is there, right? So which side we have to open the mouth? What I have told, that the mouth of a fish will be opened only in that side where the numbers are more. Jahan pe zyada ho, okay? So definitely this side we are going to open the mouth in this way, because there are more mangoes. But this part is greater than this one, okay? These mangoes are greater than this mango, okay? So the second one also, what are these? These are peach, right? So let's count. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There are 9 peach and peaches. And let's see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So where we have to open the mouth? This side, right? So we will open the mouth this way, in this way. But we will compare these both pictures, that this one is less than these. Okay? This picture is less than this one. Okay? I have told you that, I have also explained you in the board that how you have to do this, right? So this, I have just told you these two pictures, right? And rest of the pictures you have to do it by yourself, okay? So for page number 28, this part, and page number 29, this part is your homework, okay? So you need to do it by yourself. Now if you turn the page and move on to page number 30, this type of picture you will get here, okay? Draw objects in each row according to the symbol. You have to draw the objects according to following this symbol, okay? So here you have to look here, you have to be careful before making the pictures, okay? Aapko ye dekhna hai, you have to look the symbols, okay? You have to follow the symbols. Here this is the sign of equals to, and what I have told you that if this sign appears, that means the both sides are equal, okay? So these are circles, yellow circles. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 circles. Then that definitely you have to make here 5 circles, because the sign says that both the numbers should be equal. Okay. So you have to draw here 5 circles. Okay. Now here this one is greater. As I have told you, the mouth will open only in the greater part. So there are total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 triangles are there. So this should be greater. If the sign is showing that this one is greater, then you have to make here less triangles, okay? If there are total 10 triangles, then here you have to make 8, 9, already 5, okay? But less than 10, alright? Because if you make 10 triangles over here, then the both part will be equal. But the sign shows here that this should be greater, okay? So here the third one, this should be greater, right? So let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 rectangles are there. So definitely ye part, ye arrow is side mein khula hai, then you have to make your less numbers of rectangles, okay? So if there are total 7, you can draw any numbers like 5 to 6 rectangles over here, okay? I hope that it is clear. Now in this way you have to do page number 28, page number 29 and page number 30. This is your homework. Pause the video and note down these pages and do it by yourself, okay? That's all. Thank you. So kids, just now we have finished with Easy Learning Maths. Now we are going to do this book, okay? The name of the book is Let's Count 1 to 100. So all of you take out this book and move on to page number 68, okay? You will get this number, that is 1111, okay? So have a look at the board. But before that, we will learn this and we will write down the numbers and then we will proceed to the book, okay? So let's read this. Read along with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Sorry, I have written here one also. 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay? And if you move here, you will get 11 and 12. Okay, so let's try. There is one standing line, that means 1. Semicircle and a sleeping line, that means 2. Half circle and a half circle, that means 3 became 3. Half standing line, sleeping line, and again standing line becomes 4. Then again sleeping line, standing line, and a half circle, 5. One semicircle and a small circle means 6. Now for 7, one sleeping line, standing line, and again a sleeping line, 7. Now for 8, you can make in this way also, 2 small circles, and you can write in this way also. Okay, became 8. Now for 9, one standing line and a half circle over here, 9. And for 10, it's very easy, one standing line and a circle became 10. Okay, now for 11, this is also very easy, standing line, 2 standing line, that means 11. And for 12, one standing line, half circle, and again a sleeping line, that means 12. Okay, we have learned this also and we have write this part also. Now we will move on to the board, that is page number 68. Okay, you will get number 11. Now here what you have to do is, the first line, there are already the dots given, right? So you have to trace the first line and rest you have to do it by yourself, okay? And it is very easy, you just have to make 2 standing line, okay? Because this is number 11, so you are going to do this page, that is 68 and 69. You have to do it by yourself. And if you turn the page, then what you will get is, that is number 12. We have already, just now we have learned on the board, in the board, right? What we have learned, 11 and 12, that was the new number that we have learned today. So what you will do here, that is page number 70 and 71, you will get the number 12, that is one standing line and 2. 1, 2, 12, okay? So for this also, trace the first line and rest to it by yourself, okay? So have a look at the board and note down this one. This is your homework for which book? This is Let's Count 1 to 100. And along with this, we will do this copy exercise part also, exercise book part also. So this is what you are going to start in your notebook, okay? There, what it is written here, writing numbers 21 to 40. In this way, you will write this, write the question, and here you can start from 21 and you can end with 40, okay? So for this, you will get the scanning, you will get the PDF also in our school website, as I have already told you, in www.bacnews.in. So for this, as I have given you in this exercise book, you have to do in class book also and homework copy also, okay? So that's all. Thank you. So students, now we will be doing English, okay? The name, the The name of the book is Cursive Capital and Small Letter Book. Have a look at the book and take out this book, okay? Today we will do page number 18. So all everyone move on to page number 18. As we have already done the previous letters, right? Here in this book we were writing, what we were learning? The stylish one, right? The cursive letters we were learning, right? So today we will do page number 18. That is, you will get the cursive capital letter F and cursive small letter F, okay? That is from page number, we will start from page number 18, okay? So have a look at the book, what I have written here. I have already made this cursive letters for you all, that is capital and small. And today what we are going to learn, the new letter is, that is letter F, cursive capital F and cursive small F, okay? And let's do it again, and along with me, you all also have to write, okay? What I have told you in the first part before starting this, that we always use this, that is first, second and the third line for capital letters, okay? And for the small letters, we always use the second and the third line, but not for every small letters. For some of these small letters also, we use these three lines. As you can see here, it is very clear that we have used only the second and the third line for writing this letter A, that is small A. And for this small cursive small B, we have used 1, 2 and 3, that is first, second and the third line, okay? Now I will write here, have a look, and you can also write with me. So for A, from third line we are going to start in this way. Start from the third line, move on to the first, then again move on to the last line, that is third, and make a smooth circle and a tail. Became our cursive capital A. And for small, we are only going to use second and the third line, okay? That is, make a small tail over here, then make a circle in this way, moving on to the second and again to the last, and a small tail. That is cursive small A, okay? Now let's move on to the letter B. That is, we will start from the first line in this way, and then we will move on to the last one. Then here in this way we will make a circle, again a circle and a small tail, okay? Became our cursive capital B. And for small, cursive small B, here what I have told you, that here we will use, for this small letter we will use the first line, second line and the third line. We will not use this fourth line for writing the letters. We don't have to go move on to the fourth line, okay? You always keep in mind that we always use these, only these three lines, alright? So for B, start with the last line, then again move on to the first, then again to the last, and then a small circle, half circle, then a tail. That is our cursive small B. Now for C, that is all letters we have already learned in the previous class, right? But today we are just doing the recap, revision, okay? So for C, we will start with the third line. Again, move on to the first. Then a circle, semicircle and a small tail. That is our C, okay? And for small letter C, here in this setup, for this setup, we will use only the second and the third line, alright? So we will start from the third, move on to the second and a semicircle, then a C. It was very easy. Now for D, for both the letters, we will use these three lines, alright? So if we start from, we have to start from the first line, then move on to the last, a standing line, then a small circle over here, then a big half circle over here and a small tail. That is our cursive capital D, okay? And for cursive small D, what we will do here, again for this also we will be using three lines, alright? So for this, we will start from the last, then a circle over here in this way, then we will end this, okay? That is cursive small D, okay? Now for cursive capital E, that is, we will move on to the E, okay? Okay, now we will move on to the cursive capital E and the cursive small e. Okay, so for this we are going to start with the second line. Alright, in this way we will move on to the first, then a half circle, then a half circle, then in this way became our cursive capital E. And for cursive small e, what we are going to do here, for this letter we will use only the second and the third line. Okay, in this way we will start from the last line, then move on to the second, and again a circle, half circle, then a small tail became our cursive small e. Okay, now the new letter that we are going to learn today is this one, that is cursive capital F and the cursive small f. Okay, so have a look at the board. In this way we will make a small wave line over here, then the standing line starting from the first one, first a wavy line, then we will move on to directly move on to the last in this way, and we will make a sleeping line in the mid one. Okay, yeah, so you can see here now I have made this small line in this second line. Okay, ye jo small bana hai na, it's sleeping line, I have made this in this second line, all right, of your notebook. Now for cursive f, small f, what we will do is, in this way we will do make it, we have started from almost from the third one, then we will move on to the first, and again we will move on to the last. Here you can jump on to third line se bhi aap cross kar sakte ho. In this way we will make, that is F. Okay, it is little bit tough, but as you can practice, if you practice it properly, it will be easier for you all to write. Okay, so if you move on to page number 18, what you will get is, that is cursive capital F, and if you move on to page number 19, you will get small cursive small f. Okay, and if you turn the page, that is page number 21, then you will get the revision, that is the cursive capital F also and the small f, both for cursive. Okay, cursive capital F and cursive small f. Okay, so this is your homework for cursive capital and small letter book. Okay, that is page number 18, 19 and 20. And along with this, as we have already started the exercise book, right, so the homework for your exercise book is this one. Write cursive A to F. Okay, in this way you will write, not only you will not write only one time, okay, three or four times you have to write. Okay, that is from A to F. What we have learned today, the new letter was F, so here you will only write the capital letters. Okay, no need to write small letters, just write with capital letters, that is from A to F. All right, so this is your homework for your exercise book, and this is the page number for your English book, that is cursive caps and small. All right, that's all, thank you very much. So students, we have already finished up with maths and English also. Now we will be moving on to EVS and GK. Okay, that is the name of the book is EVS activity book. And move on to page number, this is page number 15. Move on to, if you move on to page number 15, then you will get this type of image. Okay, so here the question is, untangle the ropes and match the correct parts to the plant. Okay, here you can see some of the parts of the plant are over here, and here is the correct all the part of the plant, right, here is a flower. So what you have to do, there are also, you can see the dots given out, puzzle type, right. So what you have to do, you have to match this picture according to their parts. Suppose this here, it is a leaf, right, and in this picture where you can see the leaf here, so what you have to do here, you have to move over here. Okay, as you can, you have to match these parts with here, with this picture. Okay, so first one I'm going to do for you. So what you will do, this is a leaf, then you will start from here, then move on to here, then we just have to follow this dot line. Okay, this, you just have to trace it over this dot, and if in this way, in this way you can do it. Okay, similarly for this flower also, you will start from here, then you will, you here simply you have to follow the dots, follow these pictures. Okay, and suppose the dots are given over here, ye line yahan pe diya hua hai na, then you will start from here in this way. You will, if you move, it is very easy, and after completing you have to do this by yourself. Okay, this is page number 15. This is leaf, flower, roots and a stem. Okay, so now if you move on to page number 16, then you will get the flowers, the name of the flowers and the picture of the flowers. Okay, here circle the correct name of the flower. You have to circle the correct word. Suppose this picture, what, which flower is this? This is a rose. So there are the names of the flower. First of all, we will read and then we will circle. Okay, here you can see this is lotus, rose and lily. Okay, so the picture contains rose. So you have to circle this one, rose. Okay, and for the second one, this is lotus. So first of all, let's read the name of the flower, that is sunflower, lily and lotus. So the correct one is lotus, then circle this one. And for sunflower, this is the image of sunflower. Here the sunflower, rose and daisy. This is the correct one, circle this word. And this one is marigold. So rose, lotus and marigold. Here is the word marigold, so circle it. This is the picture of lily. The name is lily, rose and the tulip. So here is the correct word. You can circle it. Okay. So in this way, you will be doing this page also and page number 15 also. Okay. So this is your homework for previous activity book. That is page number 15 and 16. Alright. And also you will learn the names of the flowers. Okay. 10 names of any flowers also. Okay. That you have to learn. Alright. Thank you. Hello, bachcho. Hum logo ne padha English, Maths aur ab hum padhenge Hindi subject. Okay. तो यहाँ पे क्या लिखा है मैंने आपको पहले क्लास में भी ये आपको दिखाया था, ये पढ़ाया था. ये इसे क्या कहते हैं, अ से लेके अ तक स्वर वर्ण, ठीक है, और क से लेकर क तक उसे कहते हैं, वो आता है व्यंजन वर्ण में. तो आज हम पढ़ेंगे स्वर वर्ण. ओके, तो पहले हम ये पहले इसको पढ़ेंगे, एक एक अक्षरों को पढ़ेंगे, उसके नामों को भी जानेंगे. जैसे कि इंग्लिश में हम पढ़ते हैं ए फॉर एप्पल, बी फॉर बॉल, ठीक है, तो इसमें भी होता है अ से अनार, आ से आम. तो हम पहले अक्षरों को पढ़ेंगे और उसके बाद इनके नामों को भी जानेंगे, फिर हम यहाँ पे लिखेंगे, ठीक है. तो ये क्या है, आप सभी मेरे साथ पढ़ेंगे. ओके, तो ये है अ, आ, छोटी ई, बड़ी ई, छोटा उ, बड़ा उ, री, ए, आई, ओ, औ, औ, अह, ठीक है. तो अब इन सब ये सारे अक्षरों से क्या आता है वो हम अब पढ़ेंगे, ठीक है. आप सभी मेरे साथ पढ़ोगे, ठीक है. अ से अनार, आ से आम, छोटी ई से इमली, बड़ी ई से ईख, छोटा उ से उल्लू, बड़ा उ से ऊन, री से ऋषि, ए से एड़ी, आई से आईना, ओ से ओखली, औ से औरत, अंग से अंगूर और अब से कुछ भी नहीं होता है. ये मैंने आपको पहले पिछली क्लास में भी बताया था ना कि अ से जो ये लास्ट अक्षर होता है इससे कुछ भी नहीं होता, ये खाली होता है, ठीक है. तो हमने ये सारे अक्षरों को भी पढ़ा और इन सब से क्या आता है वो भी हमने पढ़ा. अब मैंने पहले आपको क्या बताया था, ये पढ़ने के बाद हम लिखेंगे, ठीक है. तो आप सभी अपने एक्सरसाइज बुक में मेरे साथ लिखोगे, ठीक है. तो आप लोग बोर्ड में देखो और ये सब तो आपको पहले से ही आता है क्योंकि आपने नर्सरी एलकेजी में भी ये सब पढ़ा है ना. तो ये जस्ट एक रीकैप है, तो हम ये कर लेंगे, ठीक है. तो आप सभी बोर्ड में देखिए, तो हम ऐसे करके बनाएंगे अ, ठीक है. अगर हम हाफ सर्कल बनाएंगे तो बन जाएगा, फिर यहाँ पे एक ऐसा लाइन देंगे, फिर यहाँ पे करेंगे तो बन जाएगा अ, ठीक है. अ से आता है अनार. अब सिमिलरली ऐसे ही हम आ भी बनाएंगे. आप देख सकते हैं ये दोनों सेम है, बट पीछे में हमने एक आ की मात्रा बनाया है, एक डंडा बनाया, तो वो है आ की मात्रा, ठीक है. तो ऐसे करके सेम जैसा अ है वो सब हम बनाएंगे पहले ऐसे करके और फिर एक डंडा, ये है मात्रा. तो हम अगर ये बना देंगे तो बन जाएगा आम, दैट इज आ से आम, ठीक है. अब हम छोटी जाएगा छोटी ई। तो ये है छोटी ई से, ये है छोटी ई और छोटी ई से आता है इमली। ठीक है, तो छोटी के बाद क्या आता है? बड़ी ई। ओके, तो बड़ी ई भी सेम हम करेंगे, इसी तरह का अक्षर को हम बनाएंगे पहले इस तरह से, सेम जैसे छोटी आपने बनाया ना उसी तरीके से छोटी को बनाएंगे और ऊपर में हम एक छोटा सा ये मात्रा दे देंगे तो बन जाएगा ये बड़ी। ठीक है, बड़ी से आता है इमली। उसके बाद क्या है? छोटा ऊ। छोटा ऊ बहुत इट्स वेरी इजी। तो कैसे करेंगे हम? एक सर्कल बिल्कुल अ की तरह बनाएंगे और लेकिन इसे लंबा खींचेंगे। ठीक है, तो ये बन जाएगा छोटा ऊ। छोटा ऊ से आता है उल्लू। ठीक है, उसके बाद बड़ा ऊ। बिल्कुल सेम आप सभी ने नोटिस ये देखा होगा कि कई अक्षर जो है वो सेम सेम है, बस हमने कुछ में मात्रा लगाए हैं तो और कुछ में नहीं लगाए हैं। ठीक है, तो आप जब बड़ा ऊ बनाओगे उसमें भी सेम करोगे, ऐसे ही करके छोटा ऊ पहले बनाएंगे इस तरह से सर्कल सर्कल देके, फिर यहाँ पे ऐसे करके बना देंगे तो ये बन जाएगा बड़ा ऊ। ओके, तो बड़ा ऊ से क्या आता है? ऊन। अ से अनार, आ से आम, छोटी से इमली, बड़ी से ई, छोटा ऊ से उल्लू, बड़ा ऊ से ऊन, अब री से ऋषि। ओके, ऐसे करके हम बनाएंगे एक डंडा, फिर ऐसे कर देंगे और पीछे बनाएंगे ये, तो बन जाएगा री से ऋषि। ठीक है, अब हम मूव करेंगे ए की तरफ। ओके, तो ऐसे करके अगर हम बनाते हैं एक छोटा सा लाइन, फिर हम नीचे की तरफ पढ़ेंगे, फिर ऐसा कर देंगे तो ये बन जाएगा ए से एडी। अब इसी तरह का सेम हमें आई में भी बनाना है। ठीक है, पहले हम ए को बनाते हैं इस तरह से, और याद रखें ये इंग्लिश वाला ए नहीं है। ठीक है, ये कोई अल्फाबेट नहीं है, ये हिंदी के अक्षर है। तो हमने पहले ये ए को बनाया, फिर ऊपर में अगर मात्रा दे दिए तो बन गया आई। ठीक है, ए से एडी, आई से आई लव, अब ओ औ। एंड दिस वन ये बहुत ही इजी है। ठीक है, आपने जैसे अ आ बनाया ना, बिल्कुल उसी तरीके से बनाना है। पहले हम अ बनाएंगे इस तरह से, देन वी विल हम फिर एक स्टैंडिंग लाइन बनाएंगे और फिर और एक मात्रा जो कि हमने बनाया आ में, राइट? तो यहाँ पे फिर और एक मात्रा ओ की मात्रा ले देंगे। ये मात्रा है ना हम आगे वाले चैप्टर्स में, आने वाले चैप्टर्स में पढ़ेंगे। ठीक है, मैं आपको ये मात्रा क्या होता है, कौन सी मात्रा कैसा होता है, वो सब मैं आपको सिखाऊंगी। ठीक है, तो ऐसे करके बनाएंगे तो ये बन जाएगा ओ, दैट इज ओ से ओखली। अब बिल्कुल जैसा आपने ओ बनाया औ भी वैसे बनाएंगे। ठीक है, पहले अ बनाएंगे, उसके बाद फिर एक मात्रा देंगे जो आ में बनाया था, फिर इसमें एक मात्रा बनाया ओ में, हमने एक ऊपर में ओ की मात्रा बनाया, इसमें दो बनाएंगे तो ये बन जाएगा औ। औ से औरत, और अंग और अ, ये भी बहुत इजी है, बिल्कुल अ की तरह बनाना है। ठीक है, इन दिस वे ऐसे करके अ बनाएंगे, फिर ऊपर में एक डॉट दे देंगे, डॉट दे देंगे तो ये बन जाएगा अंग, अंग से अंगूर। ठीक है, और ये हो गया अ, पीछे में दो डॉट तो ये बन गया अ, अंग से अंगूर और अ से कुछ नहीं होता है। ठीक है, तो ये जो स्वर वर्ण हमने सीखा है ना, ये पहले भी क्लास में सीखा था, हमने बस पढ़ा था, बट अब हम ये एक्सरसाइज बुक में लिखेंगे। ठीक है, कुछ इस तरह से अ से अ तक लिखो, दैट मींस आपको पूरा स्वर वर्ण लिखना है अ से लेकर अ तक, और ये आप लिखेंगे क्लास वर्क एंड होमवर्क कॉपी। ठीक है, बोथ दोनों नोटबुक में आप लिखेंगे। ठीक है, देखिए यहाँ पे लिखा है ना होमवर्क कॉपी एंड क्लास वर्क कॉपी, तो आप दोनों में सेम करोगे, अ से अ तक लिखो। ठीक है, और आप सब याद रखना चाहिए, यहाँ पे मैंने सारे अक्षर एक साथ लिखे हैं ना एक ही लाइन में, बस आप जब एक्सरसाइज बुक में लिखोगे ना तो चार अक्षर एक लाइन में लिखोगे, दैट इज अ आ छोटी ई बड़ी ई एक लाइन में लिखोगे, फिर जब छोटा उसे बढ़ेंगे ना आप तो सेकेंड लाइन यूज करना। ठीक है, एक लाइन में नहीं लिखोगे, एक लाइन में सिर्फ चार अक्षर लिखने हैं। ओके, तो ऐसे करके आप अपने एक्सरसाइज बुक में लिखोगे। आज हमने बुक से नहीं पढ़ा, आज हमने बोर्ड में पढ़ा और आपको होमवर्क दिया है एक्सरसाइज बुक में। ठीक है, सो किड्स लेट्स मीट अप इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो, टिल देन बाय बाय, टेक केयर।